Hi students, welcome to Code Java lecture 11. In this session, I am going to explain you how to write, compile and execute a simple Java program on the system. I'll show you the demo. Previously, I have explained you the theory part of this simple program writing, and also we will work on a simple Java program using primitive data types. So, first open notepad++. In this I am writing one sample file. So, sample file. First we will execute a simple sample file, and in this public static void main string args. Here I am writing one output statement, system.out.println, welcome to Java programming, semicolon, this phrase is end here, next. Now with which file name we should save it? Sample file dot Java. Why? Because this is the class name of public static void main method. So save. Where am I saving it? On desktop CVK Java folder with the name sample file dot Java. Save as type Java file only, you have to save it. So it. I have saved that file. Now go to command prompt. Go to the folder in which we have saved our file. Now Java C. What is the name of our file? Sample file dot Java. So it has compiled without any errors. Now we will execute it. What is the expected output? Welcome to Java program. So welcome to Java programming, you got the output. So this is how you have to write and execute a simple Java program. Next, let me explain you a program using primitive data types. So class data types demo class. Public static void main string args. In this you see int x is equal to 15, float y is equal to 5.9, and remember if you are using float you should give f here, double some z, some 809, something like this I am giving, d you should give. Now char some l is equal to some k value I am giving. Next let me explain boolean also b is equal to true, some string also I'll give like Krishna. Then let me print out first of all these. So what is the print statement? System dot out dot println. So I am writing here x value. So x value colon will be printed on the screen, and it should be appended with what? X value, and use semicolon. So in the same way I want to print y then z, next l, next b and s also we will print here and see. B and S. We will see how the output will be and check whether we have closed the braces correctly or not. Okay. To open braces, to closing braces. Okay. Data types demo is the name of, should be the name of the file. Save. Data types demo dot java and it should be of java type. Where is the java? Here. Save it. Now go to command prompt. Here, where is our file? Desktop. CVK Java data types demo is the name of the file, na? Java C data types demo dot Java. So it has executed without any errors. Now we'll see whether we get output or not. Java, yes. X value 15. Y value, Z value, L value, B value, S value, all have been printed. Now let me remove that F for D and then try. So let me remove this F first and see whether it works correctly or gives error. See here, float double required. Float double. So that is why you should give F or D. You should specify there F or D. Now let me take byte x 1 is equal to some 100, short y 1 is equal to 5000, and then something like double D is equal to 35E65D, something like some other value with E you are using, some character, some M is equal to 65 you will give, character, look here, character and 65 I am giving. And we will check x1, y1, dm, we will print and see how the output will be. So 4, so x1 we want to print here, next y1, so y1, next let me give here d2, here also D2, here M I am giving, here M. We will see what the output will be. Save that and then compile it. So float Y is equal to 5.9. So let me use F here. Next. Compile it. So it has compiled without any compile time error. Java data types demo. So character, if you give ASCII values, M is equal to 65. 65 is the ASCII value of capital letter A and remaining all are printed here. Byte and then short value. So let me give more than the a range of byte value, something like 1000, and here also short and check whether it works or not. So it is giving errors, range, required. Okay, so here within this only you are executing. Let me use minus sign here and check whether it works or not. So Java C compiled. Yeah, so it is taking minus values also. So here in this session you have learnt how to write a simple Java program, and then using primitive data types we have executed a Java program. Thank you, take care, and we will meet in the next session with other topic in Java. Bye.